So as an application of the concept of the flooding to determine how big our gas absorption tower is or our stripping tower is, we have this particular problem. Now for this problem, ammonia is being absorbed in a tower using pure water at 25 degrees Celsius and 180 m pressure absolute. Now the feed rate is 2,000 pound mass per hour, and that is 653.2 kilogram per hour, and it contains 3 mole percent ammonia in air. So in this case, class, you want to eliminate the contaminant ammonia in air by scrubbing it with pure water. So that's actually the main application of gas absorption, taking out contaminants from the air gas contaminant mixture. So you want to take away the ammonia from the air ammonia mixture. The process design specifies that the liquid to gas ratio flow rate should be 2.2:1, or that's your GL to GG equal to 2.2:1. And your packing material is that of 1-inch Intalox packing. So we have a pack tower using this particular packing material. You are to calculate the pressure drop in the packing, the gas mass velocity at flooding, and using 60% of the flooding velocity, calculate the pressure drop, the gas and liquid flows, and the tower diameter. So the very important part of this actually problem exercise is the determination of the tower diameter based on flooding conditions. So before we transfer to the Jamboard, I'd like you to get a screenshot of the problem. That is why you'll be guided on how are we supposed to solve this problem later on. Okay? And please, if you have your book there by John, please beside you. That way we can use the table that I have shown to you in the slides together with the flooding correlation diagram. Okay, please get a copy of Genku, please, whether it's hard copy or soft copy. That way you can supply me with the information needed. Okay, now I will transfer to the Jamboard then. Okay, wait lang. Okay. So based on the problem, we have this as given. So based on our discussion, if we are to illustrate our gas absorption tower, we have this. So this is your streams 1, and these are your streams 2. I'd like to use this one, it's easier. So you have the gas here entering the tower. This is the gas leaving the tower. This is where your solvent is introduced, and this is where your solvent carrying the ammonia leaves the tower. Now, based on what is given in the problem, can you give me the type of packing material that is being used? Can you just type on the chat box? So the type of packing material used is? You did not take a screenshot of the problem. So 1-inch Intalox packing. Thank you, Ken. Okay, I'll show momentarily the problem for those who are not able to take the screenshot. So I want you to have a copy of the problem so you can follow through what we are doing. Okay, that's the problem. Take a screenshot of the problem. Okay, so now we go back to our Jamboard. So your packing material is 1 inch interlocks. Okay. What are the information stated in terms of the streams? So you have ammonia to be absorbed using pure water. The feed rate is 2,000 pound mass per hour. So you have the equivalent in kilograms per hour. So if you stick to the English units, so you will have 2,000 pound mass per hour for the feed rate. What would that then be? Where would I place that 2,000 pound mass per hour? Where will I place the 2,000 pound mass per hour? Here on the streams? Can you see the, yes, I'm there. So where am I going to place it? L2. L2. L2 is your solvent, Ken. It is your solvent. The problem says the feed rate is 2,000 pound mass per hour and it contains 3 mole percent ammonia. So this is a problem on gas absorption. So where will I place the 2,000? Okay, correct, Ivan. It should be placed on the B1. So this should be 2,000 pound mass per hour. What is the corresponding concentration here? Y1. Based on what you have, the screenshot that you have taken. That's 0.03. Says there it's 3% ammonia. So that's correct, Kyle. It's 0.03. Now, what else can you pick out of the problem? Liquid to gas flow rate is 2.2, right? So we can have liquid to gas flow rate. Now, that refers to, in this case, that refers to, so it's written there as GL over GG has 2.2. This is also equivalent based on our representation here as liquid. So our liquid feed is our solvent, L2, and our gas is V1 fed to the column. So that's the ratio. 2.2 is to 1. What else is given? Okay, the pressure is 1 atm, 25 degrees Celsius for your solvent, which is pure water. So if this is pure water, this tells us that your X2 is 0. It doesn't contain ammonia. And the process is to operate at 25 degrees Celsius, same as the condition of the feed, and a pressure of 1 atm. So you are required for, so what are you required for? Pressure drop, gas and liquid flows, and tower diameter. So you have 3. So you have to indicate that all in your solution. So you have delta P, liquid and gas flow, so referring to this L1 and V2. And you have that very important tower diameter. So liquid and gas flows, by the way, it refers to the L1 and V2, all the flow rates here possible, okay, in this case. So we go now to the solution of the problem. So if you recall our discussion, the very first thing that you are to determine when you intend to determine the size of the column is the pressure drop. What information do you need to find the pressure drop? What information do you need? So you have the formula as 0.115 times the packing factor. So based on our slides, times the packing factor raised to what? What's our formula for that? Anybody able to get it from our slides? No one? So let me just go back to it. I'll just get it from here. So it's 0.115 times the packing factor raised to 0.7. So we raise this to 0.7. Okay? That's it. Now, how do I find the pressure drop? Where will I go? I need to find the packing factor. So where will I get the packing factor? That should be taken from a table, right? It should be taken from a table. I'll show to you the table just in case you don't have your Genpo, please, with you. So we'll find that very important table. Okay, so this is the table you find for 1-inch interlocks. You have here interlocks, Norton interlocks. See that? We'll settle for the one, the 2T, Norton interlocks packing, which is 2T. And you will find the packing factor for that to be here on the last column, to be 17. So since you're using the English set of units, we'll use the English unit here for the packing factor. And that's 17. Now, can you see it? Norton interlocks. It's in the structured packing material. Your packing factor for that is 17 per foot. You also ought to get that as well in your handbook. So I'll go back to the Jamboard and write our FP. So FP is equal to 0.17. So your pressure drop here will be 0.115 times 0.17 raised to 0.7, giving you a pressure drop of, can you solve for the pressure drop? You have 0.033. Thank you, Kyle. So you have 0.033. Okay, I got it right. So 0.033. Now, what are we going to do after you have taken the pressure drop? Actually, this is already the answer to the first requirement. If you have the pressure drop, you can get the flooding linear velocity in this case. But before you go to that, I'd like to show to you the appropriate figure where you're going to get the flooding velocity. So I'll go back to our slide. So this is our slide. And we're going to use the appropriate figure. So in this case, this is for random packing. So we're not going to use that because our interlocks packing material is in the structured packing group. So meaning you're going to use this one. They look the same, but only in the graduations and the scaling of the values do they differ. So this one is for your structured packing. You already have the value of the delta P. So the value of 0.03 is somewhere here below. So this is 0.05. So probably if you'll have this distance here, as this must be 0.025, so 0.033 is somewhere here. So you're the ones going to approximate where the delta P is going to fall. So you have, this is more or less, if I'm going to annotate, it would be more or less somewhere here, class. If this is 0.025, it's 0.033 somewhere here. But not really this one. So, doamula na siya. We're going to approximate it. Okay? But what is important in here, why I went back here, by the way, it's inch water per foot of packing material use. The units I used a while ago is lacking of the unit of pressure because it's delta P. It should be the pressure drop. So in this case, you need to take note of this. We have to determine the flow parameter. That way, using the flow parameter and the delta P computed, which is 0.033, we can find the capacity parameter. Okay? So I will please get a screenshot of this. It's GL over GG times rho G over rho L raised to 0.5. That's our flow parameter. Okay? We need to determine that. So I'll go back to our Jamboard. So solving for flow parameter. So your flow parameter, I'll just place this as x because you're going to base your x coordinate there is equal to the ratio, the liquid to gas ratio, multiplied to the density of the gas over the density of the liquid raised to 0.5. Now, so far in the problem, you're already provided with the GL to GG, and that's 2.2. So this is already known. What you need to know is the density of the gas and the density of the liquid. So in this case, the density of water is the density of water at 25 degrees Celsius. Okay? Can you please get the density of water at 25 degrees Celsius from any property table that you have there? Let me get it also from my end. We have already the density of water. So at 25 degrees Celsius, okay, 0.9970, that's correct. So this is the density of the liquid. Point 9970. So this particular density value has the unit gram per ml. So can you please convert this in cubic feet, pound mass per cubic feet, because we're using English units here. What is the value in pound mass per cubic feet? Okay, we have 62.25. Thank you, Maisel. How are you?
Hello, Miss. I'm okay, Miss.
That's good. So pound mass per cubic feet. So you have that density already. Now, for the density of the gas, if you notice, class, there was no mention in the problem as for the density of the gas, knowing that your gas is in the form of a gas mixture, a mixture of air and, in this case, ammonia. So we'll just base it on the major component that is present in our gas, which is that of air, because your ammonia is just 3 mole percent. In our ammonia air mixture. So can you get So we'll just approximate it anyhow. The value will not differ that much if the problem does not give, but oftentimes the problem gives it to us. So for air at 25 degrees Celsius, we will use its density for the rho g, the density of the gas. Can you get the density of air at 25 degrees Celsius? Okay, I have it here. It's 1.19 gram per liter. So kindly have this converted in pound mass per cubic feet. Okay, sakto na siya itsolo, 1.19. We'll have this converted to pound mass per cubic feet. So your units have to agree. So in this case, you have 0.0. Please just check. 0.0739 pound mass per cubic feet. I got it from Google. So the density of air at 25 degrees Celsius in pound mass per cubic feet is 0.0739. So we're going to use that. So for your capacity parameter, we can now solve for this one. So we use the value of the ratio of the liquid to gas flow rates, which is 2.2, and we'll have the rho g. We'll use the 0.0739, and we'll divide it by 62.25. Since we are dealing here with ratio, by the way, class, if it's difficult for you to convert, it's okay because anyway, your conversion in the numerator and in the denominator will just cancel. So you can deal with, as long as the units of the densities are the same, it doesn't matter, okay? Since we have here a ratio. So your capacity parameter in this case is. Is this correct? 0.0758, the one that Kent gave. My answer is 0.01970. Okay. So Mel is correct. So this would be our flow parameter. So kindly take note of the X and the delta P because we're going to go back to our figure for the flooding correlation here. So 0.01970. Okay? Sige. So now we go to the Jamboard. We're already in the Jamboard. I'd like to go to the slide.
Miss,
Yes.
ang sa X ba lang?
Ah.
Ang sa X ba lang, Miss? Hindi, 0.5 ang exponent. Or 0.7. Kaya ang sa
Oh.
formula mo, Miss, 0.5. And then
I forgot.
pag-solve, nag-0.7.
Okay. I missed that one. So it should be point.
Okay.
Okay. Sala si Miss. Nadaraan ko di sa packing factor. So this should be 0.5. So it should be the square root of that. So 0.0739 divided by 62.25. And then we get the square root of the answer. And multiply it by 2.2. Oh, chapter si Kent. Sala, gini ni Miss Ali. Okay. So we have 0.0758. So take note of that. 0.0758 and 0.033. Go back to our figure. Again, we check if we're using that of the structured packing. So if I annotate here, probably the 0.033 is somewhere here. And it's 0.07. So this is 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. This is the 0.05. The 0.0767, 0.075, no? So it's in between. And you go up and approximate more or less where is your 0.033. I'm not sure if that you will agree that it's somewhere here. Your delta P is 0.033 with this much of the flow parameter, which is 0.0758. So I'll just approximate it in here. Your capacity parameter then will be somewhere here. Okay, that's where your capacity parameter. And this is your formula for the capacity parameter. Kyle, kindly take note of the formula. I will miss again probably the correct exponents there. Okay, so we'll go back to our Jamboard and then substitute or equate this value of the capacity parameter to this expression for it in here. Okay? So we'll just settle for around 0.028. But if you're in right on the middle, it's 0.3. So 0.28. Okay? Where are my markings? 0.28. So we'll go to the Jamboard. Your capacity parameter is more or less 0.28. So you can even write 0.3 if you want. And this is equal to, so based on the formula that is written, this is our y. So it's the linear velocity of the gas. Were you able to get it, Kyle? What is the expression of the flow parameter? Okay, I'll just get it. You have rho g over rho l minus rho g raised to 0.5. Why am I going back to this? Hey, class. Am I on the... So you are to multiply this with rho g over rho l minus rho g raised to 0.5. Then you have the packing factor raised to 0.5. Then you have the kinematic viscosity raised to 0.5. I'm not sure if it's all 0.5. Were you able to check it based on the figure?
1.05 sa last na term is.
0.5. Ah, okay. So try. You have 0.5, 0.5, and 0.05. Okay. So that's what I missed. So this should be 0.05. Your goal here is you will find this one, the linear velocity, the flooding. Okay? So the value of 0.28 will be equated to this. All the rest of the value should be known. That way, we'll be left with the linear velocity. So in this case, class, the packing factor is known. The densities we have known, we have already determined. So we go now to the kinematic viscosity. Now, the kinematic viscosity will be the kinematic viscosity of water. And we can determine first the viscosity of water. So, mu at 25 degrees Celsius for H2O. Can you please give me the viscosity at 25 degrees Celsius for H2O? So at 25 degrees Celsius, you have will have this in centipoise. Okay, 0.890 centipoise. Okay, 0.890 centipoise for water, but this particular unit of centipoise is ano, this is for SI and we're dealing with English unit. So there's a corresponding so I say there's a corresponding conversion from centipoise to pound mass per R per feet squared. So there you have to use that one. So let us go back to the slide and check for the follow for that particular conversion. Okay, let me check. Structured packing. I'm wondering why this will not move here. Okay. Here. It's not here anymore. If we have to convert it all in English, it has to be multiplied to 28,570. I can't find it anymore here on the slide. Because, it's already in height. So let's just go back to the Jamboard anyway. It's just the conversion, but it's 28,570 to convert from centipoise to pound mass per hour per feet squared. It should be in English. So converting this to that set of English units, this has to be multiplied to 28,750, I think. So this would be equal to, can you give me please the value? Or if you have your Gianco please there with you, you have a sample problem. He has a sample problem there which has this particular conversion. So you can check on that as well. So if you multiply 0.890 CP to 28,750, this would be, $25,587.5. Okay. Does anybody there has a Janku, please? Because I don't want us to use something that I may have given wrongly. So can you please check first? I give you 2 minutes if this is really the conversion of the centipoise to the English set of units. I'll try to check it also in this slide here, on the slide that I have, because I can't find it anymore. Okay, we'll check here on the other slides, Vikasa. I'm sure it's just here. I hope my memory serves me right. It's a sample problem on flooding velocities. Can you just check it? I'm also looking for it in here.
Nang, excuse me, miss. Ah, siya sa example 10.6-1.
Can you please check the conversion na lang? Is it 28,000?
Nang, bali, miss, ang gamit niya ni centistokes, mandi, miss, gin-divide niya lang 0.89377 sa
No.
0.99708.
We're using now the viscosity. Okay, we're using the viscosity. We're going to convert the viscosity in centipoise to centistoke. So doing that will need the density. Oh, correct class. So it's in here. Wait, ha, I found it already. You have to convert your where is it? The mu. To pound mass per hour per feet. Now, it's already given as it is. Wait, class, huh? Okay, the 28,572 is in the conversion of the interfacial tension, I think, in dying per centimeter to pound mass per hour squared. So, hindi na siya amo. Maisel? Is it you, Maisel?
Miss.
Okay. So, what was used there for the... Is it really the kinematic viscosity that was used directly?
Nang, oo, miss. Pali, ang mu, gin mu over density, miss, ang
Oh, yeah.
pag-solve sa hindi.
Sang centistoke. So, your mu... Wait, ha? The mu that was used is in centipoise. So my concern is that our mu is centipoise. So I want to convert it to English prior to dividing it by the density. So the centipoise unit was used directly. It was not converted. I think there's a certain conversion there. What is the conversion that was used? I don't have my Jan Kukris here. It's in school. What's the conversion that was used? That's correct. Your kinematic viscosity is your, this one is equal to mu divided by the density. You cannot divide something in, ano, in SI, the centipoise, to the English unit, which is in pound mass per cubic feet. So what was the conversion for the mu first? Is the mu that is given in centipoise micelle in the sample problem and it was directly divided by the density in English?
Gin directly lang miss ng divide sa density.
So there's no conversion of centipoise to English set of units?
Wala miss.
Okay, sige. So wala na sa conversion. So we will use the centipoise directly and we'll just divide it by the density to give us the centistokes because that's my
Oh, miss, I'm not getting over it. I'm not getting over it.
Sige, sige. So thank you, Maisel. So in this case, there's no need for us to convert the centipoise unit to centistokes. So using the centipoise that we have here, so 890 centipoise, we divide it by the density of water that we used a while ago. So the density of water that we got is in pound mass. The density of water that was used, Maisel, I think is in SI. Is it in gram?
Miss SI, please.
Okay. So it's in SI, so 0.9970. So that's okay then. If we're not going to use the English, so 0.9970. Gram per ml. This should give you a unit in kinematic viscosity of centistokes. Okay. Can you give me the value here? So it was really good that we checked on it because I myself is really forgetful about conversions. So you have mu over density of 0.90 divided by 0.9970. How much is our kinematic viscosity? Please supply the answer there. Just write it on the chat box. Excuse me. What's your answer in Simpson-Stokes? 0.898963 or 26? 0.8963. 0.890 divided by 0.9970. 0.8926. Okay, we have that. Then you go back to this capacity parameter and substitute everything. So with the value of 0.28, we equate it to VG. That's the linear velocity of the gas and everything, the density of the gas, 0.0739 divided by density of water, 62.25 minus 0.0739. We raise this to 0.5. Then we have the packing factor, which is 17. Check. Yeah, it's 17. We raised that to 0.5 as well. And we have here the kinematic viscosity of 0.8926. So in here, you'll get the linear velocity of the gas. This is the linear velocity of the gas at flooding condition. So meaning at this velocity, your column is said to be flooded. Can you please get the answer for the linear velocity? Use this equation that we have here.
Ang last nga variable miss erase 0.005.
Okay. Thank you, Mel.
Ay, 0.05 yung miss.
Ah, 0.05. Okay, I missed. So that would be 0.28 divide by 0.8926 raised to 0.05. We also divide it by 0.17 raised to 0.5. We multiply it with 62.25 minus 0.0739 raised to 0.5. And we divide by 0.739 raised to 0.5. My value here is 19.815. Kindly check if that is your value as well. 19.815. 19.815. So this is, since this is linear velocity, this must be feet per hour. Okay? Now based on, okay, correct. So based on what you have learned in your thermodynamics, you already have the linear velocity. How are you supposed to find the cross-sectional area of a particular section where something, where your fluid is flowing? This is your linear velocity. How will you find the cross-sectional area which will lead to the diameter of the column? What do we do? Okay, before that, since this is the velocity at flooding, So with this velocity, your column is already flooded. This is the linear velocity of the feed gas to the column. We need to, based on what the problem is saying, we're only going to use 60% of this flooding velocity. So we're going to okay, wait, Kasha. Okay, so you can see now my screen. We're going to multiply this to 60%, okay? So you have 0.60 of Vg is equal to your answer there times 0.6. So 11.8890. So this is feet per hour. Now, what do we do next? If this is our 60% of the linear flooding velocity, how do we find the cross-sectional area? Velocity. Velocity times what? Velocity times area. Velocity times area is equal to volumetric flow rate, right? So area is equal to the volumetric flow rate. This time, since this is at flooding condition, we're going to use the volumetric flow rate of the gas. Now, the problem gives us the, in this case, it gives us the, this one, the mass flow rate. So, what do we do with the mass flow rate? So, it's 2,000 pound mass per hour. Now, if you're going to divide this, equal to, if you're going to divide that volumetric, this particular mass flow rate with the density of the gas, which is in pound mass per cubic feet, is 0.0739. This is in pound mass per cubic feet. We get to convert from mass flow rate to volumetric flow rate, which will lead us to the area. Okay, so this is, so if you divide 2,000 by 0.7039, that should give you 27,063. So this is now in cubic feet per hour. Now in this side, you will have the area. You multiply it with the velocity. Velocity, which is just 60% of the flooding. We don't use the flooding velocity because our column will be flooded. So at this much lesser velocity, which is 11.8890 feet per hour, you equate it with 27,063.60 cubic feet per hour. So you cancel the per hour unit, you'll be left with an area of 76.36 square feet. Okay, wait. Okay. And then Kent already answered us the diameter. So your area is pi d squared over 4. So our answer there, which is 2,276.36, should be equated to it. The diameter then would be times 4 divided by the pi, and we take the square root. So why is it very big, like this? 53.83. Okay. 53.83 feet. Why is this so big? Weight class half. Is our computation here correct? We can't have that relatable value for diameter. Oh. Can you check, Maisel, as to the formula of the capacity parameter, if this is correct? I am in doubt of that particular figure, whether the exponents are correct. Are the values that we have here 2,000 pound mass per hour to be converted to volume should be divided by the density. It should be this one. And we have this one divided by 11, we have this. This is too big for diameter. There must be something wrong here in the formula. Or maybe something wrong with conversion. And there's nothing wrong with conversion because densities anyhow, without being converted, will just be the same. Are the values that I have here correct? Class, please check. Because a diameter of 53.84 feet is very big. Even if you're going to divide it by 3.28, 16 meters, your column is 16 meters. That's too much. Is the value that I'm using here, Maisel? Can you check? I'll project the problem, Maisel, ha? If I have the correct values in the typewritten problem, maybe I don't have the correct values there.
Sige, miss.
That's the given in the problem.
Nang pareho siya, miss. Ang lait lang ang feed rate.
Nga.
Kay dere, ay ang given, miss, lain di. Kay 2,000, at dere, miss, 1,440 ang given.
1,440, but it's in pound mass per hour.
Miss.
Okay, so there's nothing wrong with that. 1,400.
Ang iyang given, miss.
Okay.
Then, ang iyang percentage, miss, 50% ang there sa Janko, please.
But this problem, I think, is also based on Janko. This one is 60, so there's not much difference. What's the computer diameter there in the sample problem?
Ang diameter is 1.446 feet, miss.
But that's very small. Wait lang. Ah, okay, Kent is saying it's 1.446. So can you check in which part I'll project the solution, Maisel, ha? Maybe a wrong formula or what? Because these types of problem are just procedural in nature. We determine first the pressure drop so that we'll get the flow parameter. So the flow parameter, we just substitute the ratio. The ratio there that is in the problem, more or less, is just one digit, right? One digit lang.
Ha-ha.
And
two
then,
lang siya, miss.
Two. So this
Lamay
is
malang.
2.2. You have this.
Mm-mm.
Your flow parameter is in decimal, right? Small value.
Ah, miss.
Okay. Then we go to the capacity parameter. The computed value of the linear velocity, ours is Where is that? It's in here. Can you check? It's 19.815. More or less, the linear velocity that you have there is this one also.
Nang ano siya, miss? 6.663 feet per second siya galing niya, miss.
Feet per second. Wait, ha? Nga kagamay. Pila siling mo ang linear velocity?
Nang 6.663 feet per second, miss.
But we have comparable values with the kinematic viscosity. Comparable maning values, ha? Nga
Miss,
din.
ang 0.17 bala, miss? Nga, F na. Miss. Nang, amog na siguro ang layo, miss. Kaya ang sadyan ko, please, bala, miss, nang 56. Saya.
Can I change the packing material?
Miss.
Miss.
Amo na ang dako nga difference, good miss.
0.56, this mine is 0.17 only. Check to man ang kwa ko.
Nang 56 whole number sa miss. Hindi siya.
Wait ha, wait lang. 56, ba si 17 ni class? Wait class ha.
17 siya guro, miss, hindi 0.17.
My goodness, tingala ko nga hindi giniya bilibabo lang answer nato niya. Wait lang. They'll check ha. Arriving. I go to the table. Ayun, lock class 17. Wala man ka mo gareklamo. Aragali o. As I've said, these types of problem are procedural. Pero magsala man lang substitute mo. 17 class, hindi 0.17. Ibotang ko 0.17. Ara o, 17. So, okay lang man kamo nga 0.17 yung butang ko. Wala nyo kong correctionan. Please next time, check the values that I'm putting in. It's 17. So, muna dako-dako. I go back, ha? I-redo ta ni. Dali man lang ni. You help me out here. So, this should be 0.70. Wala naman ko, 0.17. So, this is 17. Okay? So, this is 17. So, pila ni, madako ni siyang value niya sa capacity parameter magamo ni. Can you please help me out? Pila ni siya. Ang AP. You have 0.8356. See? 0.8356. Ato na siya sa babaw. 0.8356. Now, take note of this. If this is 0.8356, and please take note of this 0.0758. I'll go back to the graph, ha? Structured packing. Okay, so this is 0.8356. Ari na di siya, oh. Gari na siya sa babaw. 0.5 ni. I'll just use the annotations. If this is 0.5 and this is approximate ko lang 0.5, 0.6, 0.7, 0.5, 0.6, 0.7, 0.78. You go up until you reach 0.8, ano? 0.8 plus. Ara siya, oh. 0.5, 0.6, 0.7. 0.0758 to siya. So, dere. I go up and an AP of 0.856. So, si amuni. More or less amuni siya. So, your capacity parameter is not as small as the one you got. Kari siya, oh, dere na siya dampe. Or dere siya. So, we'll just approximate it to 1.3. Okay? Muan ko 1.3, ha? Let's see if our answer would be believable now. 1.3. So your y is 1.3. Not 0.28. One point three. So this one dot one, so this is 1.3. Please help me out here. Can you solve for the VG? I'll solve also from my end. We'll see if the linear velocity will be a lot smaller. 1.3.8926 raised to 0.05 divided by. By the way, sorry, here we go again. The packing factor is only 17. 17 raised to 0.5 times. Raised to 0.5 divided by 0.0739 raised to 0.5. Hi, Slamat. A VG which is believable, 9.20, correct? So a VG which is 9.20. So this is different. This is also different. This will also be different. Okay. So this is 9.20. Multiply it by 0.6. This would be, see, it's only 5.52. So this will be now 5.52. Right? A linear velocity of 5.52. But the area would still be very big. If this is the linear velocity at Tading, times 0.6 of that, you will have this 5.52 volumetric flow rate. The density of the gas, it should be based on the density of the gas. Wait, ha? 0.07 siya. 39. Ow! Sorry. The unit for the linear velocity is per second, feet per second. This is per second. So this is per second. Okay, we'll just convert. So your feet per second times 3,600. That would be your divisor for the 27,063.60. An area of 1.36. Kindly check my value class. And that will give us a smaller diameter. One point three six. So if you get to multiply it by 4 and divide it by pi and take the square root of our answer, that would be 1.317 feet. Okay? So more or less comparable to what we got, what is there in the book. Okay, so the culprit is the packing factor, which I copied erroneously. So it should be 17, not 0.17, but only 17. Okay? And there are these very important things that you need to take note of. The unit of the resulting linear velocity should be in feet per second, that feet per hour. And there's no need for you to convert the SI units of the viscosities as long as you use the SI unit for the density to get the kinematic viscosity unit of centistokes. So you have 8926. Okay? Any questions so far? As for the flows, the flow rates that is being required here in the problem. So what should be the flow rate? How do we determine the flow rates? The flow rates that is given there in the problem are actually without the flooding should be the flow rates of the entering streams, because there's no way that you can determine the flow rate of the living streams because you only have one given information. So in this case, you need to determine the appropriate flow rate for these two without the flooding. So as I have written here, your GL to GG is 2.2. That's equivalent to L2 is to V1. So if you have the V1 already, so L2 to V1 is equal to 2.2. And your L2 from here, your L2 is equal to 2.2 V1. The thing is, we need to determine the flow rate V1 not in the flooding condition, but only 60% of the flooding condition. Now, how do we determine the V1, the flow rate at 60% flooding only? How do we determine it? I'll go back to this part of the solution. How do we determine the volumetric flow rate at 60% of flooding condition only? What do you do? If I may ask you, how do you find the volumetric flow rates or even the mass flow rates? What would you do? And maybe what you could do is you solve it backwards. So you solve for the product of the AV with the V used is this one, the 5.52. So this is the diameter, this is the area. We'll use this area, which is 1.36 square feet. Okay. So the area times the velocity will give you the volumetric flow rate. So the area is 1.36 square feet. I took it from there. And the linear velocity that you're going to use is 60% flooding. So that would be 5.52 feet per second. So you will have here the volumetric flow rate V of V1. That's the volumetric flow rate of V1, which is, okay, we'll compute 1.36 times 5.52. That would be 7.5. 51 cubic feet per second. If you'll have this converted per hour, you will multiply that to 3,600. You will have 27,025.92. This is cubic feet per hour. Now, that's your volumetric flow rate. Now, you have this ratio. You have this ratio here. Sorry. You have this ratio 2.2 for L2 and V1, and L2 is 2.2 V1. So you can get L2 already. So L2 is equal to 2.2 of the value of the V1 that you got here, which is 27,025.92. So this is the volumetric flow rate of your solvent at 60% flooding. You just made use of the ratio of the molar ratio of the two. So that would be times 2.2, and that would be 59,457. Fifty-nine, 457.02. The thing is, these flow rates are volumetric flow rates, and normally what the problem gives us are mass flow rates. So how are you going to convert from this volumetric flow rates to mass flow rates? So I'll write here V1 so you get to see it in one page. 27.27025.92. So these are in cubic feet per hour. How do we convert this set of units to pound mass per hour? We have done it a while ago. How do we do it? This one is in cubic feet per hour. So how do we convert it to mass per hour? Sakto siya, no? Multiply siya sa 3,600. How do you convert it to mass per hour? What would you do?
Density, miss.
Okay, you make use of the density. So what will you do here in this case? You multiply by the density. So L2 is equal to 59,457.02 times the density. Since L is water, our density should be in pound mass because this is English. So we go back to the density of the water. Pound mass per cubic feet. So 62.25. Okay, I will not anymore write the unit because anyway, it's pound mass per cubic feet. The cubic feet will cancel. For V1, you have 27,025.92. We multiply it to the density of air. So the density of air is 0.0739. And you will have your corresponding answers here. So your 27,025.92 multiplied to 0.0739. That should be 1,997.22 pound mass per hour. This one, your column will not be flooded at this particular mass velocity. The problem gives us a velocity of 2,000. So that's a little bit higher than the 60% here because actually, theoretically, what is being used is just 50% at flooding. For this one, it would be really higher because your multiplier here is very high for the density of water. So for your 59,457.02 times 62.25, you have, we'll just place it in exponential value. So 3.7170 times 10 raised to 6. So this is pound mass per hour for the density of the liquid water, no, for the mass flow rate of the liquid water at 60% flooding condition. So actually at the 2,000 pound mass per hour flow rate of the gas, your column is not yet flooded because it's just a little bit above the 60%, which is higher than the 50% requirement for the column to be flooded. Okay, so for the flow rates, this should be your answer. The flow rate of the gas and the water at 60% flooding conditions. Okay? What is important in the use of the flooding correlation diagram and the table where we get the packing factor? What makes it very important is for us to be able to know the size of our column, and that has something to do with its diameter. Okay, so this would be the procedure for it. When I say procedure, it's really by procedure. So you just simply pick out the correct values from the correct table or diagram. Now, any question here on the topic of determining the column diameter, the size of the column? There's none. Okay, I will update your slide later, the one that is shared to you in Canvas, by putting the sample problem there. That way you can cross-check it with the solution in this recording. Now I go back to the slide and continue with column height. The procedure in determining the column height is really very tedious, but I have already placed in Canvas a PDF copy of the screenshot of the procedure in determining the column height for your information. Okay, so we'll go to that now. As for the flooding velocity for a tray tower, you will just have this particular procedure to follow. Obtain the tray factor case of V, find the entrainment gas velocity given by this formula, and choose diameter so that the velocity that you'll be getting is just 70% of the computed V max here. I leave it to you as is your responsibility to read the sample problem in Canvas on determining the diameter of a tray tower based on its flooding velocity. May ara sample problem si Jen Ku, please, on this. The approach is not exactly the same, but more or less the same as that for the determination of the diameter of the column based on the packing materials that are being used. That is in the case of the pack tower. So we can go. So this would be your diagram for that. In the diagram, you also need the plate spacing, which the problem actually gives. Gina-specify, gina-asang problem ang plate spacing. So read the sample problem on this portion here of the design of your tower. Now we go to the column height. If you go to different sources, the handbook, Jen Kuplis, and even McCabe and determining the column height, there are a lot of procedures in determining the column height, even a lot of formulas to choose from. So you choose the formula which will, of course, make use of the data that is provided in the problem. Why am I saying that? Because based in the handbook, you have several formulas in determining the column height. The Z, which is the column height, can be computed based on the product of the HG and the NG, HL and the NL. Now, you use the HG, NG product if the problem is on gas absorption, as such, because you have the subscript G here. You use the HL or H sub L, N sub L formula if the problem is on stripping, because that way, in this case, your feed is liquid. You use the formula Hog-Nog when you are given gas absorption. You also use the Hall-Null when you're given stripping. Okay, now what are these H sub G, N sub G, H sub L, N sub L, the Hog-Nog or the Hall-Null, as we shortly read the formula. So they are all defined in here below. And you could see that we use only the those with subscripts L for stripping process. And for gas absorption, we use those that have subscript G. Your N sub G is the number of gas phase transfer units. And whenever you see the O together with the G, that's already the number of overall gas phase transfer units. The formula in determining the N sub G and the N sub OG are different. So, dapat ang pares-pares gid ang sundon. So, if you intend to multiply HG, it has to be with NG, not with NOG. If you intend to multiply NOG, it should be with HOG, not HG. Okay? Your H of G is the height of one transfer unit based upon gas phase resistance. So, the reason why you're using the representations here with the subscript G on gas absorption is because your mass transfer is based on gas phase resistance because it's gas absorption. In stripping, of course, it would be based on the liquid phase resistance. The definitions of the N's here and the H is the same as here with the different subscript, but only it's for stripping. If you come to think of it, if you have the height of one transfer unit, the height of one transfer unit, that's the height equivalent in the column which you consider as one mass transfer unit. If you multiply it to the number of transfer units, then that would be the overall height of your column. So I think it's very self-explanatory. The height of just one transfer unit multiplied to the number of transfer units will give you the height of your column. So if it's based on the overall gas phase resistance, then you'll be using the representations which has the subscript O, the OG, or the H with the subscript OG together with it. Okay? So please check on your handbook on the these formulas indicated in the corresponding equation. So your ANOG and your NOL, this is taken from Jian Kuklis. Really comparable to class the formula in determining the number of stages, if you recall, using the Kremser's equation. The formula is dependent on the gas absorption factor A, the Ys and the X, and the slope of the equilibrium line or curve. It's dependent on that. In your handbook, you can find the NOG and NOL on this equation and your HOG, HOL on this equation. Okay, please check on your handbook on these equations. Then, for computing the tower height using film or overall mass transfer coefficients, for dilute solutions, you can refer to these equations in Jan Kuplis. And for concentrated solutions, you refer to these equations as well. I did not write it here anymore because there's just so many of them based on the specific application. We distinguish concentrated solutions from dilute solution and the fact that dilute solutions has concentrations which are less than or up to 10% only, while concentrated solutions have more than 10% as its concentration. Now, we can also use the HETP concept and finding the Z. So the HETP, however, class needs the hug. So if you're using HETP times N equation in determining your tower height, you must first determine the hug. So some would rather have the hug directly computed and solve for the NUG and multiply the two. That would still be giving you the same Z. But if the problem gives you already the HETP, all you have to do is determine the theoretical number of trays or steps using Kremser equation and then multiply that HETP. Because what is this HETP? It's the height of your packing material equivalent to one theoretical stage. So this is how tall or how thick your packing material is inside your pack tower for it to be considered as one stage already. So if that particular height of packing material is multiplied to the theoretical number of stages determined using Kremser equation, then you'll be able to determine your column height. Okay, that's the Z. So the Z based on HETP times N. So it could be based on that. Okay. So this is same for both packed and tray tower and for parallel operating lines and equilibrium lines only. So it is suggested that you use this formula for the Z when your operating line and your equilibrium lines are parallel. If they are slightly not parallel to each other, there will be a slight variation in the z, but isn't it's not that much. Okay, if you use this particular formula, that will be shown. Actually, that is shown in the PDF copy of the, I think, five different procedures of determining your z, which is already shared to you in Canvas. Because there's no way for me to have it photocopied as discussed with you last meeting because of the cancellation of classes. So this is a sample problem on determining the column height. I think for this sample problem, the answer is 3.07. Okay, wait, class, ha? I'll just edit. If this is 3.7 or 1.36. Let me project it again. Sorry, class. It's not shared to you. Okay. And on the next slide, you have this PDF copy of the procedure of finding the column height. Let me click on this. Let's see if we can view it. So this is actually the procedure. So you have in here five different procedures or four different procedures, if I'm not mistaken in determining the Z. So this is one procedure. The process is actually t-juice. This is the second procedure. This is the third procedure using the HGNG. This is the fourth procedure using the HETPN. I had all of this used. That way, I can illustrate to you how well the variation in the answers would be if I use different formulas. Will be there great variation or not? So, yes, I have. And this is the fifth. Okay. So, five different procedures of finding the Z. As to be expected, class, you see in the last procedure, step out na siya. Ito mo na determine na sa iba niya procedure ang inog dapat substitute sa iya. Actually, it's not that short, because there's a lot of things that needs to be determined prior to determining the Z. We will discuss this. We'll alter again the scheduling, our scheduling. This would have been fast. I could discuss this probably in an hour because everything is in here already. I need not write anything on the board. So the answer is 1.36 something. Wait, Rosa. Cover height. These formulas here are based on GNP, please. Okay, aside from the formulas using HGNG and HETP, they all have more or less the same range of values. I will discuss this to you the next time we meet. I will check on our schedule and how can I modify the schedule that was given to you last meeting. Probably what I'm going to do, I'll just quit sharing here because it's almost time. And I know your brain cannot anymore process what I'm going to share with you. So I'll just stop sharing.